being, you know, losing eligibility for that we want to avoid. And sometimes it's just around educating you guys on what to look for. And so we're going to talk about that. You know, and what really started my shift from the pharmaceutical industry over to health and wellness was about 5 years ago. A friend of mine is a personal trainer. She still is out in California. She has a TV show on Bravo, a workout show, and she was telling me that she uses a supplement line that was very safe, and I started to look into it, and that's when I started my business, and it's with a company called AdvoCare. Have any of you heard of AdvoCare? One here in the front? Two? Cool. Three? Awesome. And I'll give you a little background on that. This isn't an AdvoCare business meeting at all, but I do want to tie it in because it is it's a really reputable, high-quality product line that will allow you to not have to worry about your eligibility. So we'll talk about that too. But before anything else, really what we're going to focus on is just you guys being the best versions of yourself. And, you know, as student athletes, I think there comes a responsibility with that. And, you know, you guys juggle a lot every day. You're trying to be the best in the classroom. You're trying to be your best on the field. Some of you are here on a scholarship for sports, so, you know, you feel that that has to come first. And, you know, then it's in the way that you handle yourself off the field, too, that you have to pay attention to. And so that's a lot of responsibility for young athletes coming out of high school, leaving home, transitioning into being independent. And, you know, and sometimes I think that can all come together and maybe get a little bit lost where, you know, you don't know how to balance that time. And so we're going to talk about that as well. I'm going to give you some ideas for good nutrition options, so things you can take in your bag and take with you to practice, things you can make in your rooms, things that, you know, if you don't have access to a good, high-quality kitchen that are still going to fuel you for better performance. And then also, we're going to talk about other things like how important sleep is, and some of you may have given up some of that sleep to be here today, but we're going to talk about the importance of sleep. So I always like to start with role models. Role model, I mean, the definition of a role model, I put it up there, but it's really somebody that exudes an example that other people want to follow. You know, you want to be somebody that people aspire to become. And it can be a catch-22 because when you're a student athlete and people come and watch you perform, they almost make you a role model based on what you do on the field or on the court. And sometimes, you know, without really knowing who you are as a person, you're put into that category. And that can be a lot of pressure. So it's how do you conduct yourselves, you know, in a good way that younger kids are going to want to emulate. So we're going to talk about that. You know, and it also comes with just carrying yourself a certain way. You know, I think asking yourself every day, you know, am I being a good positive role model? Am I somebody that I would want my brothers or sisters to look up to? You know, what am I posting on Facebook and Twitter, and who am I hanging out with, you know, is this good quality people? A friend of mine, his name is Walter Bond. He was a former NBA basketball player, but now he's a motivational speaker. And you guys can Google him or YouTube him. But I love one thing that he says to athletes, and he says it to people in general, but he says, you are the average of the five closest people that you hang out with. So if you, on your hand, if you think about your five best friends, chances are you all share same characteristics. You all, you know, if there are five successful people, then your odds of being successful are going to be right in there with them. If they are doing good things in the community, chances are you are too. So ask yourself, you know, who those five closest people are, and you want to surround yourself with people that are going to make you better and people that you can help make better. So, you know, also think about things like where you're hanging out, you know, where am I spending my time in good places? That way, if somebody just happens to see me out and about, you know, am I somewhere that is going to be a good option to be found? You know, a lot of times you might just be at the grocery store and some young kids who have come to watch you play are there with their parents, and they'll say, hey, you know, that's such and such in the checkout line right there. You know, are you smiling? Are you interacting with people? You know, just the simple little things, and a smile can go so far. So, you know, just think about that as you're kind of out and about. But nutrition really plays a big part in how you handle yourself too, because the more energy we have, the better we feel about ourselves, you know, the more confident we're going to become. And so when we talk about nutrition, I always hear the same excuses from athletes. You know, I don't have time to eat. I'm always busy. I'm on the go all the time. You know, I want to get an extra 30 minutes of sleep in the morning, so I'm skipping breakfast. And all those things, you know, while they might be, you know, that 30 minutes can sometimes feel like an extra 5 hours of sleep and you want to hit the snooze button. If you're not fueling yourself in the morning right away, that's going to set the tone for your whole day. So it's making that investment in yourself that doesn't take a whole lot of time to do it. So, you know, asking yourself, am I making the time to really understand what I'm putting in my body? Because your body is what is allowing you to perform. And we only have one body. So we have to take care of that and make sure it's working at its highest level. One of the things that's pretty easy to incorporate into your day is just eating small, frequent meals throughout the day. You know, and that can be just little snacks. It doesn't have to be a big sit-down meal, but you can just pack it in your bag, put it in your pocket, and I'll give you some ideas of what some of those frequent meals can be, what they can look like. But athletes are burning a lot more calories than most, you know, most kids our age. So, or your age, I'm not a kid anymore. So, your age, but you need to even eat more. You need to eat more calories than most people are. You need to eat, you know, make sure that you're giving your body everything that it needs from a mineral and vitamin standpoint. And it's important to eat all the time. You know, so a lot of people think, well, I'm trying to cut weight, so I shouldn't eat as much. That's kind of a myth, because the more you eat, the higher your metabolism gets, the more fat you burn, the leaner you get, the stronger you get. You know, that food is going to be good for you as kind of the best supplement that you can get. So I put a picture up there of some logs and a fire, because it's the best way that I know to explain how your metabolism works. And if you think about your metabolism, you want it at a high level, burning fat, burning calories, working for you from the second you get up in the morning. So if you think about it like a flame, that's your metabolism. So most people, when they want to cut weight, they say, I'm not going to eat. So if you don't eat, the food that you bring in is like the logs you throw on a fireplace or on your campfire. So if you're not eating, nothing's going on it. And what happens is it burns out. It stops working. There's no fire there. You want your body to be at its highest level. So you want that flame really high. And in order to keep a fire going, you need to put a log on it every couple hours to keep it moving. So think about your food the same way. You know, it's important that you get that. And breakfast would be the number one place to start, because skipping breakfast puts your body in sleep mode. So how many of you had breakfast this morning? A lot of you? Some of you? All right. The ones that did are raising their hand really high because they're proud. They're like, I had breakfast. The other ones didn't. So you might still be kind of dragging right now, you know, not feeling real good. Your body's still kind of asleep. You know, while your friend next to you, whose hand was up real high, is already burning, man, their metabolism is working. They're just sitting here and they're turning. So, you know, fuel yourself in the morning. So some of the good ideas that you can have, you know, just on the go. One of the mini meal ideas that I tell my athletes, and these are things I give my pro athletes too. I mean, they, you know, they keep it basic. They don't have time to mess around either. So college and pro athletes love it. But dry cereal is something that can be affordable to you on your budget. There's really good choices in high protein cereals that you can get. If you go to the grocery store, I like the Go Lean cereal. That's one that if you just measure it out and it says it on the box, 3/4 of a cup of that, just put it in a Ziploc bag. It'll give you over 10 grams of protein, gives you about 100 calories, and you can just snack on that throughout the morning. So that's a good option. Obviously avoid your Fruity Pebbles and your, you know, your Fruit Loops, but even though it tastes good, it's not really going to help you perform.